Hey, good morning. I'm working on a 2013 15-inch MacBook Pro Retina. I was taking a chance at buying some units, some more expensive MacBooks, trying to fix those. You kind of got to front a little more money. Surprising how much the people still want for these things broken. And was hoping to get lucky to buy ones that just required board work and Retina displays were okay. That's a tough find, to be honest with you. Retina displays are extremely expensive to purchase. They do not just sell the panels where you can remove it from the casing and put it in. They sell the entire case, the whole upper part of the MacBook. And they are very pricey. So that's the worry because if you're lucky enough to get them for a good deal, you might not be able to sell them for much profit, if any at all, by the time you replace the screen. Especially if you also have things to do like replace hard drives. The majority of them do not come with hard drives, so you're going to spend some more money there. So I took a chance and on two of them, a 13 and a 2015. But the 2013, I replaced the screen and the unit worked, but occasionally, and I didn't take the board out immediately to check anything. It looked fine as far as on the top side went. I ended up running it and it would work, it would boot. But occasionally the screen would just go completely dark. I rebooted, it would come back up, it'd stay on and be fine. And then, you do another reboot, and in the boot process, it'd just go off, or it might boot and a few minutes later, just go off. So I pulled the board to take a look. There was no liquid damage on it that I had found. The only thing that I found was looked like physical damage. A little tiny resistor over here, which I'll show you on the microscope, was pushed off, broke off. Looks like it must have been hit by a tool of some sort. Sometimes this thing was not easy to line up for you guys. So just this little guy on the right. It was completely snapped off. I didn't even really look to see what it was for. I guess I could go to the schematic and board view and take a look at it. Let's see what it go to. Not even sure I know. LED, LED, LCD, HDMI connector, LED return. Looks like it actually went to backlight. So that may have caused some problems. But what I did is put it back together. It didn't make any difference with the cutting out. So at that point, you already kind of know it has something to do video related. The MacBook stays powered on, fans are spinning, just no image. So off the top of my head, I know if I start checking voltages coming off of the LCD connector, I'm probably not going to see voltage on GPU Vcore. I didn't check it specifically. I just kind of had that assumption. Should probably check it, but I can't take credit for anything. Other people have found that the issue ends up being related to this graphics chip, or not the GPU itself, but this other chip. And this chip is dealing with GPU Vcore. Pop this guy here. And ultimately what they suggest is reflowing it, resoldering the joints on the edges. They don't look the greatest. The manufacturing of this board seems kind of terrible. Some other things I noticed is a lot of these solder joints, they just got solder balls all over the place. Like this little guy here on a couple of these guys. Focus here for you. See them little shiny balls up at the top? Those aren't supposed to be there. Little guys. And don't belong. I mean, that's not something you want bouncing around to get cause shorts. You could tell, I mean, they've been there since manufacturing. Look how hot they were. With little indents. And that's not the only one. I found others all over the place. Oops, I must have dropped that one. And all the little chips that kind of look like that one. See? There's more. Terrible. These things are so small, too. They're like a speck of, you can't even really see it on your finger. It's crazy. So I'll probably give this board a little clean, some form of cleaning here. But ultimately what I'm going to do is what they suggest and has been successful is basically resoldering this. So I think I'm going to do that with my micro pencil and some flux. And which flux do I want to use? Overboard. See another. I don't know what this is. Could be a shaving of aluminum. Screw hole. Ooh. I'm adding just a little bit of new solder. feel like you could just go around and solder everything on this board, make them all shiny again. Probably ain't an actual bad idea. Does. So it's pretty much happens just about every time I turned it on. I'd get some form of a black screen somewhere short in the boot or in the middle of using it. Misplacing my tweezers. Terrible with that. Did I join one over there? Looks like I did. Fix that. Nice little wobble. No way to really stop it unless I tighten that right there. And then I can't move it. pop it back in. This has probably been the most pain in the ass board to get in and out that I've dealt with so far. More shit in the way, that's all. These little things. In between that. Now I gotta pull. Yeah, last time. It was just easier not having this. Screw in. Obviously, you need to be out of the way. There we go. All right. Put some screws back in, not all of them. Just make sure it's in place. Just to make sure. She's been waiting for you, so.
Huh?
June's been dying for you to come out.
Are you
recording.
Right
here.
Yeah, it's okay. I'll be down in a couple minutes for morning coffee. Love you too.
Maybe one of these days I'll edit video and speed this process up so people don't have to watch it, but until I become a video editor, You have to fast forward yourself.
Connector.
All right, antennas and camera. It's multiple times I've done that. I'm gonna break it one of these days. I repaired one of these little antenna wires before. I tell you, it's tricky. These things are small and not easy. All right, I think we're good. Plug the battery back in. I do not have a hard drive for this one. It does not work. The one that I purchased, I had the wrong adapter. Then I purchased an adapter that fits, but does not appear to be correct. Ooh, I'm not done. Almost forgot that. All right, now I'm done. See that? It's delamination of the anti-reflective coating. Apple had a program, unannounced program, to trade these in or bring these in and they would give you a new screen that has not been announced, so people don't know about it really. But this model is going to be too old for that. It's past the time frame. Kind of sad, considering you should be able to bring it in at any time. Wasn't sure if the backlight was on these retina screens. It's a little harder to tell. Now, a lot of times it just boot right around here, even boot up, screen come up, and then go down. Sometimes it will boot and work for a little bit. I'll use it, I'll shut it off, retry it. So we'll try it a couple times, see what we get. What's crazy is how well these machines run off of an external SSD going through a USB port. They run fast. Pretty surprising. So far, so good. Some videos or something. So this one I gotta get a hard drive for still. Once I do and clean it up, I'm debating on selling or keeping. I haven't quite decided yet. 2015 I'm going to be selling, but the screen on that has some of the delamination too, and that one I think may be eligible for a trade or get it swapped. So I'm going to try to do that and get a new screen on it before I do that, before I try to sell it. And that unit is in great shape. It's very, very good shape. So far, so good. This is good news. This normally would already have happened. And what I bought was an adapter to accommodate an M.2 PCIe. PCIe M.2 drive. Ugh, this stupid thing. One of these days, I'm going to figure that out too. Better camera. Well, it's a good camera, it's just it's not meant for being open like that the whole time. And the adapter does fit. It has the right number of pins. It says it's for 2012, but so far the 2012 and 13 seem to be pretty universal. Anything past that does not work. Not the greatest solder quality on this thing either. Something. It's a little too long, even, so I wouldn't even be able to cut it to make it fit. This adapter should have been way up here, and if that were the case, I could probably get it to fit. So, gotta find something better. The other ones I can use these, I don't know if you can see where there it is. It's just like this, pretty much, fits right in. Either way, this thing doesn't recognize it. Doesn't see the drive. So I'll look for another adapter. In other words, I gotta buy an original Apple drive, which are just more expensive. See, it doesn't list it. Only the external. But, good news, screen stayed on. So I think we're good there. Call that a fix. And then get this thing sold or make it my personal one. Well, have a great day, guys.